My listeners, how are you doing? This is Reverend David Saki. I want to say God bless you today. Today I want to encourage someone who is losing faith, who is just losing faith because of things that are going on in your life. I want to encourage you to have faith. Jesus Christ said in Mark chapter 11, verse 22, have faith in God. What that means is have the faith of God, or the God kind of faith. This faith believes in their hearts and says with their mouths what they believe in their hearts, and it comes to pass. So Jesus said, have faith in God. And then he said something very profound in verse 23. For verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. It means that if you have a mountain, you have a circumstance, you have a difficult situation, you are in a midnight hour of your life, you are going through some difficulty, or there's a challenge, there's a mountain, you can, in Jesus' name, say, in the name of Jesus, mountain be leveled, mountain be gone, circumstances be gone, sickness, I rebuke you in Jesus' name. I confess my faith. I confess, the Bible says, hold fast your profession of faith without wavering, for he that promised is faithful. So I want to encourage you to confess, command circumstances that are not good out of your life, and confess circumstances that are good into your life. The Bible says that death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruits thereof. Thou art snared by the words of thy mouth, thou art taken. So what we say, as we keep confessing, they can become a reality. So from now on, I want to encourage you not to confess negative things, not to say negative things about your life, not to say negative things about your future, not to confess negative things, but confess the good report. The Bible says that we must confess the good report, the good things. Whose report do you believe in? Do you believe the report of the Lord, or you believe the report of what people say? So confess whosoever. And the same word whosoever in Mark 11, 23 is the same whosoever in John 3:16. So if whosoever in John 3:16 means me, you bet whosoever in Mark 11, 23 means me. So from now on, the Bible says, and we believe it. So once you have a situation that is difficult, confess it out of your life by the word of God. And then verse 24 says, therefore I say unto you, our Lord Jesus said, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. So verse 23 is confessions, verse 24 is prayer. When you pray, believe that what you have prayed about, God has given it to you. What things soever you desire when you pray, believe at the point of prayer, as if God was right there with you and you were speaking to him physically, and he said yes, he will do it. Once it's in the word of God, it's the will of God. Once you pray according to God's word, you are guaranteed he will do it. So what things soever you desire when you pray, believe you receive them and you shall have them. Now when God gives you something and you believe you've received it, what do you do? Everyone will thank God. Everyone will praise God. So it means that right after prayer, start to praise and thank God, because you know that God has given it to you. God bless you. This is a quick, short word of encouragement for you. Shalom.